Howdy guys, OniLink here, and welcome back to Xenoblade X. Last time we took on Fog's ridiculously difficult affinity mission. Today we're going to be taking on Boze's. And for this one, to get to this one, it's basically in the very southern end of the upper level of the administrative district. So basically from the Blade Tower, start heading down the right path and then turn right. And it'll be way at the end over here. So, let's take it on Boze's way.
Sensei! Sensei, it's terrible! It's Clarissa's team. They'll all be killed if we don't do something. But what can we do? Who's going to... where can we possibly... Sensei! What do we do?
Cut! The greater the crisis, the calmer a soldier must remain. I taught you this, did I not? Have you already forgotten what you learned under me?
No, Sensei. Right. I'll explain from the start. Do you remember Clarissa, Sensei?
I never forget a student. She was the same year as you. I heard a number of you Academy kids formed a team together. Anyway, go on.
We lost communication with them. All of a sudden, just silence.
I see. Know where they are.
I asked HQ to put together a search party, but they don't have anyone available.
Then I'll go look for her myself. So, can I ask you to come with me? Please. I can't break any more promises to these kids.
Promises? Wow, Sensei. You still remember that?
Of course I'll help, but not for you, Boze. I don't like you. I'm helping because it's Blade.
I will not forget this. You have my word.
Thank you, Sensei. Thank you, too. I know you'll do whatever it takes to bring Clarissa and the others home alive.
All right, then. Off to King Long Glade. And let's go find Clarissa. So we're heading to FN Site 212. Alright, Skell, are you ready? I'm sorry about the beating I put you through last time, but we've got a bit of a mission. Okay, thankfully it looks like she's very close by. Oh, hello. Just keep going. Here we go.
This was a damn massacre. But where does it leave us? Hey, you've explored this region before, haven't you? Any idea where Clarissa and her crew could be?
Probably a ganglion base, to be honest. They're the only things that would be willing to attack and then kidnap someone.
True. I can't imagine indigents would be capable of this. But the ganglion? Very possible. And if so, they may have taken their prisoners to a nearby base. These are the benefits of a partner with experience. Let's make for the nearest base. Clarissa's waiting.
God, I hope we can find her in time. Alright, off to the ensconced cathedral? Alright then, up to FN Site 211. Okay, where are we going? Oh crap, we're down in... Okay, this is not a good spot to be. We're down in a pit. Hold on. Yeah, we're down in a pit. We're not getting out of this easily. Let's see then. Let's head up to... FN Site 214 instead. Okay, where are you taking me? Oh, hey, we're back here. Alright. Damn it! That's not gonna work. Fine. Then let's just go ahead and drop down here. And and follow the follow ball. Oh, right, this place. Okay. Yeah, the, ensconced cathedral that we, went through once or twice while looking for the EM drive. Well, shoot. This is gonna be real pretty, isn't it? Okay, I'll just leave my car here. It's basically a car. Don't deny it. And let's get inside. Okay, carefully. Hopefully, nobody will spot us. Okay, so far so good. Let's take the outer wall. Careful, don't be spotted. I could take him, but I still don't want to be spotted. What's my levels? Oh, pretty good on everyone. Oh god, level 28 Tyrant. That looks pleasant.
More Earth aliens. Come to watch us kill your people.
If you lay a single finger on my student, I promise you, I'll have you begging for death.
Beg for death? Earth alien is funny.
Oh, I'm serious as the grave. If you have the guts to try me,
then come. Save your friend. If you can. If you make it to me, I will release her.
Don't do it! He killed them all! He'll never keep his word. He...
Silence, Earth alien! Believe or not, choice is yours. But if you flee, she dies.
Let's go. I'll not see another student of mine murdered by some Xeno animal.
Again with the racism. Also, no. Damn it, Demetrio the Tempestuous. I don't want to fight you. Okay, made it inside. Now let's just climb up until we get far enough away to break the... to break the lock on. Come on, Demetrio, let it go. I should have come in through the back, shouldn't I? That would have worked much better. No, Fog, you cannot. You're doing fine. Just keep running. Running is the best solution here. And we're out. Alright, we'll come back once the enemies have dropped us. Jesus Christ, there's... Finally! Okay, let's head in the back route this time. Instead of just charging in head first. That was dumb. Alright, up to the middle level. Oh crap! God damn it, you scared the shit out of me! Oh, that was a dumb move. I'm trying to be stealthy, not trash talky. Holy crap, what's with the acrobatics, Fog? That was pretty cool. Alright, almost got him.
I won't miss this chance.
Almost got him. Come on. Pronel, go to hell. Got him. Okay, now let's take the back road in. Head around to the front. And we got a prone rampager. Okay, let's get in there. So no other guys sneak up on us. Is everyone in here? Please get fully in here so we don't have to worry about drawing the attention of anyone outside.
Stop.
Ah, once again, I'm an idiot and use trash talk. Without thinking. Hopefully it didn't draw any attention. Alright, I'm gonna save Iron Prison for the next fight. Crap, the one on the outside did in fact see me. Oh god, they all saw me. Fine, here we go, Iron Prison. Alright, Boze is back up, thank you, murderers. And this is why I don't want to use trash talk. Because now everyone's after me. Alright, another one down.
Now get in there! Here goes!
Now peek it!
Upper head! Wild slash!
Holy crap, where'd he go? I just sent him flying.
I won't miss this chance.
Ah crap, Boze is down again. Okay, I can use Iron Prison again. No fog, we're doing fine. We're not doing fine. I'm running. Okay, well, I killed several of them, so... Oh no. And I fell too. Oh, this is just the worst. Welp, I'm dead. How am I not dead? We can't take them. Don't be confident. Confidence is a bad idea. Alright, I'll be back once I get back in the base. God damn, I need to stop using trash talk. That's a terrible move for this situation. Alright, I'm back inside. The first guy's almost down and I didn't use trash talk. Ah crap, we drew more attention. Of course we did. Of course we drew attention. Well, you're our next target, so just go ahead and die.
Fire carnival! Triple the
overload! Don't use trash talk, that would be a terrible idea.
I won't miss this chance.
Alright, got him. And the prone rampager's next. Guess he came down from upstairs. Alright, Iron Prison. Hang in there, Fog. If we can kill this guy, we should be fine. No, crap, there's one more up there.
Sorry,
reinforcements. We can take them if we're smart.
Ah, what the hell? How did I draw the attention of the tyrant? Alright, I'll be back. And once again, I'm back inside the cathedral. And it seems that just area of attacks and area of effect attacks in general are just terrible ideas. Although this one should be fine since it's only enemies ahead, not enemies on an upper level. Okay, if I can kill this guy, then I'll wait for my guys to. Oh, Jesus Christ, again? This is stupid! This is the second Affinity mission in a row where these guys just keep respawning and then use unfair tactics. Where the fuck did you even come from? Fine. Iron Prison. God damn it. Die. Saw that coming. Okay, I'm pissed as heck and I'm not gonna take it anymore. That's more of a movie reference to a movie I've never even seen than actually what I'm feeling. I just felt like jumping around up here with my skill. Let's say we hop on up to the middle and take you on. Screw climbing.
Look who arrives. Funny Earth alien, stronger than expected.
More like better with a, more like better with a strategy than actually strong.
Ah, yes. We did promise release, didn't we? Very well. Now she will be free. Now, so much for show of suffering. Earth aliens are prey. Die too quickly.
Damn you. Xeno scum. Why must you always be such monsters?
Monsters? No. Earth aliens are monsters. Now scream. Scream as we kill you. As all who stand against Ganglion scream.
Well, can't say I saw that coming. Alright, Zealot Glenar. Go to hell. How dare you kill her? What the fuck? Don't worry, Clarice. We'll avenge you. Okay, one down, two to go. Careful, don't fall off or we're gonna be screwed. Okay, almost there. Hang in there, murderous. Hang in there, fog. We're almost done. Are you kidding me, murderous? How do you suck so badly? Oh god, don't fall. Alright, one left. Wait, who the hell are we targeting? No target. This guy! Up here! Here we go! Back on target! Bye, Boze. How the hell did we end up fighting the wrong person, though? Guess we attracted the attention of the guys down below. Okay, prone fighter's climbing back up. Okay, almost there. Make sure we have a shield up. Come on, just a few more hits. Almost got him, got a little bit of healing in, and got it. Oh, thank God.
I failed them. Again. Damn it. They're gone. All gone. All but Reggie, stolen from me. What good am I? What purpose do I serve if I can't keep a single promise?
Boze, I'm sorry. It's hard for me to care about you because I hate racist people, especially racists who would willingly kill people of different races and aren't just prejudiced assholes to them. But it's not fair to you that you're losing your students.
Several of my students from the Academy were given spots aboard the White Whale. Shortly before it launched, they invited themselves into my home. One last hurrah before leaving, they said. And so we talked and drank until dawn. And as the sun rose, I gave my word that we would someday return to Earth together. But the damn Xenos killed them all. First on Earth, and now here. Now, I wish only pain and death on Xenos. They can never be forgiven. Do you think it's strange if I take Clarissa's dog tags? I just want something of her to live on back home.
God, you're bitter. I mean, yes, depressing. Your students are being killed. But it's the Ganglion, not all Xenos. The Monarch are trying to help us. The Orph are trying to help us. The Nopon are trying to help us. We have so many allied Xenos. Why don't you focus on the actual enemy instead of just blindly blaming everyone else for your problems?
She was one of my best and brightest. The first to earn a spot aboard the Whale. That's the moment Reggie started training like mad. Most obvious crush I ever saw. He made the cut at the last minute, but only just. You're without mercy, friend. But I thank you. Such discipline keeps me on the true path. All right. I have the tags. Will you grant me a moment to offer up a prayer for the departed? I need her soul to find the peace it never had here on Mira.
Fine, I'll give you your moment. Not for you, though. For Clarice.
Thank you. It means everything to me.
Buddha, hear my prayer. Namu Abhidhamaya!
Sorry to keep you waiting. Let us head home.
Buddha? Really? You're a Buddhist, and yet you wish death upon all Xenos. Okay, you're an asshole and a hypocrite and a racist and a hypocrite! Okay, I don't like this guy at all! Holy shit, Boze. Well, at least we learned a new art for him. Alright, let's get out of here and do some heart-to-hearts. Fuck you, Boze. I mean, yes, I agree. It's very sad that Clarissa died. It's very sad that all your students are dying. It's sad that everyone dies. But god damn, this guy just pushes all my buttons. Alright, back to NLA. Alright, back in the barracks tonight, and it looks like Elma is ready for her final heart-to-heart. Oh, hello. Sorry about that, I was just lost in thought. Or maybe it's more accurate to say I was getting a bit sentimental. When exactly did this place become my home? When did I grow to love it so? So many unexpected things have happened, you know? And yet, humanity has begun to lay down roots on this planet in spite of it all. I don't know, maybe that's why I feel like my perceptions have changed a little. When I finish a mission and return to the barracks, it really feels like I'm coming home. Honestly? I can see that. It is our new home, and I think we're starting to get used to it. I think we're starting to figure out how to handle this planet. It makes me happy to hear that. Did you know that our floor is unique within the Blade Barracks? Oh, we're on a specific floor? Oh, that makes sense, actually. Our quarters are larger than those of the other teams, and also come with the biggest kitchen. I've been blessed to be able to share them with only with the people I trust completely. Nagi and Vandam are even allowed me to bring Lin and Tatsu in here, despite her age and his, well, him. It was good of them to make that all happen. Honestly, it's probably your rank. Even if you aren't a colonel anymore, you do have rank to pull. You do have influence. No, I'm afraid that's not it. Blade has no ranks, not in a practical kind of way. I mean, the only people who really care that I'm a colonel are Irina and Gwyn. Think about it, would you and Lin really want to live under the same roof as someone you had to address as colonel all the time? No, rank means nothing here. Anyway, if we have another opportunity someday, I might tell you more about it, and about me. But for now, we should drop it. I know you're busy enough without me taking up all your time. We completed going home. And that is all of Elma's, heart-to-hearts complete. Now for Lin's fourth heart-to-heart. Is she ready for it? Nope, not yet. Alright, let's go change the time then and find out where hers is at. Next up, we have Lin's fourth heart-to-heart, which should be somewhere in Barista Court during the evening. Where are you, Lin? Lin? I know you're around here somewhere.
Did you hear?
Guess what?
Shoot! Where the hell is she?
Oh, hey!
I know she's somewhere around here.
Did you hear? Ow!
There she is. She's just off the back end of the barista court. Hi, Lynn. Hey, how's it going? I was just about to go shopping to get ready for dinner. What do you feel like eating tonight? No, let's not cook Tatsu. I like Tatsu. You know what? I'll take care of dinner tonight. I can totally cook. Whoa, really? Okay. What do you want to cook? Do you have a specialty? I have no idea. Let's have some barbecue. That actually sounds really good. I want some barbecue now. Shame I live in an apartment and can't really have a barbecue or anything. Barbecue, huh? Well, that's not really cooking, right? Isn't that just barbecuing? Although, they do say protein is good for building stamina and muscle. Eat enough of that stuff, and before long, you'll start looking like Vandam. Alright, barbecue it is. I'll go buy some meat. We completed dinner discussion. Alright, next heart-to-heart. Next up, we have Doug's second heart-to-heart over here in the industrial district by the West Gate. Hey! I was just asking the nice lady here to pull together some extra first aid kits for us. My next mission could involve run-ins with a pair of tyrants, possibly at the same time. Ooh, god, that sucks. And if we end up in a tough fight, we're likely to suffer multiple injuries. I can help, if you want. Oh, I don't think we need to go that far. I have my job to do, and you've got yours. I'm grateful that you'd look out for us like that, but it isn't right to let you carry the whole weight of Blade's mission on your shoulders. Aw, but I've done like 33% of it on my own already. Wait, no. No, it's, 38.66%. I actually just wrote it down for some reason. You have to trust that I can handle this. Of course, if all goes horribly wrong, we'll call for reinforcements. In that case, you might get a chance to help out after all. Oh, that reminds me. I've got the mission under control, but there's something else that I could use your help with. It's a significantly greater threat than the mission I just told you about. It might even, be an exaggeration to say that it concerns the fate of humanity itself. What I'm talking about is... the development of the Skill Flight Module. There aren't enough replacement mimeosomes in the world for me to survive in these field tests Lynn's running. What? Hey, I thought you wanted to help. Don't blow me off now. Hey, listen, I'm being serious here. Alright, we completed Caution and Conviction. And I would be glad to help out with the Skill Flight tests. I don't think Lynn's gonna kill me. I mean, injure me, maybe. I'm gonna have to go to the Mimeosome Maintenance Center a few times. But I'm not gonna die. I'm the protagonist, after all. Except I'm not really the protagonist. I'm more of like the guy who's just along for the ride. It's more Elma and Lynn who are the protagonists. Alright, next heart-to-heart. Turns out it's with Doug again at the sports complex. Hey, Doug. Hey, you see what's going on over there? No, what's going on over there? People playing, sports. Those folks on the tennis court are doing everything completely wrong. Tennis isn't a balancing competition, you know? So what's everyone getting all excited about? Oh, I see it now. That's actually kind of funny. Oh my god, I love the details of this game. Fog, you're invading my personal space. I mean, I love you, but... Oh my god, I can't stop laughing. This game is just too funny. Unintentionally so, I love this game. Well, you know what? They have their own games and you have yours. Huh. So you're saying I should think of tennis like a deck of cards, something with a common set of pieces but lots of ways to play. I wouldn't say what they're doing is tennis, but they are reusing tennis tools in a different way. So yeah, we should be proud of them for being creative. I don't know if I buy that, but if they're having fun, more power to them. So what brings you here? Honestly, let's just go ahead and say we came to watch the aliens. You gotta be kidding me. Here I am mocking them and you're telling me that this is a hot new sports craze that's sweeping NLA? There's no way. Although I guess we are away on expeditions most of the time, huh? That makes it pretty tough to keep up on local trends. Well, I'll make sure to tell my fellow Blades back in the barracks that balancing on tennis net posts is blowing up right now. Oh no, what have I done? That way they won't make the same mistake I did. Oh my god. We've completed Discipline and Discovery. Oh, yet another great heart-to-heart. I'm liking Doug's heart-to-hearts. His are great. All these heart-to-hearts are great. Oh, this is just...
great.
I love this game. I'm having a good time. Okay, next heart-to-heart. Alright, the last heart-to-heart we're doing today was with Lau in the morning, over here in the residential district, apparently aiming to fire at somebody in the commercial district. Who are you sniping? Ah! I was just doing some target practice. We may be mimeosomes, but our skills still weaken if we don't stay in shape. Maybe you could give Shingo some firearms training. Get some practice in for yourself and for him at the same time. I'm sure there are lots of things I could teach Shingo that would give me a chance to sharpen my own skills, but honestly, I don't have that kind of time right now. And besides, his fighting style and mine are just too different. He'd benefit more by from being trained by a specialist. Though I bet that sounds like I'm just making excuses, doesn't it? No, I think you're fine. No more questions? You're not gonna pump me for details? Thanks for that, your trust means a lot to me. Listen, if you get a chance, could you give Shingo a hand with his training? I know he'd be excited to work with someone as skilled as you, and I'm sure there are plenty of things you could teach him. Hey now, I'm not a specialist. I thought you said he needs a specialist. Thanks, I appreciate it. Alright, we completed teamwork. Alright, and that's all the heart-to-hearts for today. Next time on Xenoblade X, one last affinity mission, followed by the rest of the heart-to-hearts available at the moment. So, I will see you guys next time.